everybody, and welcome back to Royalty Soaps. Now, I put on Facebook that I was going to answer a lot of your questions because for the past 2 months I've been doing the order and I really just haven't had a lot of time to answer all of the big long messages that I get about soap making and about my family and all of that, so I just decided to make a video. Now, I'm just gonna kind of pick these randomly a little bit. I've already scrolled through and read all of them on the Facebook post. The one that got the most thumbs up is from Morgan. And it says, how soon before your Etsy shop really started picking up, and what social media site is your favorite from a marketing standpoint? Actually, believe it or not, my Etsy shop was not the first way that I started selling soaps. The first way was I had my own website and did it through PayPal, and I had that about 6 months before I got my Etsy shop in February of 2011. I think it was about 1.5 years, though, after I had the Etsy shop that things really started picking up. And even though I use my Facebook regularly, I use Twitter regularly, I used Pinterest, I used everything to try to get my name out there, I just wasn't getting enough fast enough. It was really, really discouraging, and I really, really wanted to quit about halfway through. And I told my mom, I was just like, I'm done, I don't care no more, I'm just not gonna do it, I won't make soap for fun, but Royalty Soaps is done, I'm just done with it. But she said, honey, you haven't been doing this for very long, okay? I know it feels like a long time, and you're trying so hard to get people to, you know, come and purchase soap and like your stuff and, you know, give you feedback, but it's just, you're gonna have to wait. And I think the best piece of advice I got was from Miss Karen Moreland from Mead & Secret, and I think she said it was about 5 years before hers really started picking up, so don't expect miracles. Miracles do happen, but don't expect them. My favorite tool for social media, honestly, most of my sales and most of my everything comes from YouTube. Now, I know that's not exactly a form of social media necessarily, but that is what I use for networking that actually connects me with the most people and that I have had the most traffic from, if you look at my Etsy stats. The second thing is Facebook. So if you're not willing to do a YouTube channel because they take forever, Facebook. Facebook was the best because I could share it with all of my friends who could share it with their friends. You could make the page and offer discounts, you know, exclusively for Facebook likers and stuff. And it kept all of my everything organized, and Facebook was just easy integration for my business. And I found that I had the most traffic from Facebook. I think that's number two. It's my number two for traffic. So first one is YouTube, second one's Facebook. The other thing that everyone really, really wanted to see, Miss Marcy said, it said, this isn't soap related, but a while back you mentioned about doing a video to introduce us to your whole family. And yes, that is still going to happen. That's still in the running. Believe it or not, I am actually, am I gonna tell y'all this? Yeah. I'm actually starting a second YouTube channel. This is not going to be soap related. It's going to be simply vlogs mainly and hauls and stuff. Enough people found my first channel interesting enough and wanted more of my family that I just decided to go ahead and just make The Royal Life, which is going to be my second one, and I'm just going to film everything that we do around here. Ooh, my computer's beeping. Sorry about that. I'm just gonna kind of film everything we do around here and things that I'm doing and books that I've read and essentially let you guys into my life as kind of a lifestyle channel. So that video will probably be on The Royal Life in the next month or two. Another thing that I got a ridiculous amount of requests for is how to prevent soda ash and how to get rid of glycerin rivers. I wish there was a one-size-fits-all answer for this, but there is not. So, I'm gonna tell you what causes both of them. Water discounts or water additions, milk, fragrance oils, colorants, and your oil chemistry. So that's pretty much everything. Pretty much everything causes that. There's no way for me to tell you, oh, this will fix it instantly, because it's not an instant fix, it's a chemistry fix. You have to go back, you have to look at what oils you're using, you have to look at your lye solution, you have to look at your additives, blah, blah, blah. It's a trial and error thing. There's really not a quick fix for that. You're going to have to work really, really hard to perfect your recipes. I have seriously gone through, by now, 150 recipes, around that, 125 to 150 recipes. It took me forever to figure out what I have figured out, and I'm still have not finished getting anywhere close to learning all that I need to learn. So I can't exactly answer that question because there's so many reasons. However, I will leave some resources below to the Soap Queen blog and to Soaping 101. Those two ladies have made videos on both of these and give a little bit more specific help and tips. Another thing that I have been asked, and get this asked a whole bunch, is what fragrance oils I use and my recipe. And you know, guys, this is something that I just really can't share. And I feel really bad about it, but here's what you can compare it to. Magicians work really hard to get their magic tricks ready, right? And then they do it in front of a whole bunch of people. It's kind of like when you ask me, well, what's your recipe? It's kind of like going to a magician and saying, how'd you do that? Well, like, the whole reason that he's doing that is for a profession and to make money, and he's put a lot of effort into it. He's not just gonna give it away for free. So don't waste your sweet little fingers typing me that question anymore, because I'm afraid I just am probably never gonna answer that. As far as cheap supplies go, which is another one of the questions down here, I can't remember who asked it, but as far as inexpensive supplies go, Nature's Garden candles, if you buy in bulk, the bigger sizes of fragrance oils are probably the least expensive that I have personally found. And as far as oils and such go, I use Soaper's Choice. Of course, I also buy like 50 pound pails of coconut oil and palm oil. If you want to go cheaper than that, try Wholesale Supplies Plus. Another thing that I've been asked is, do my soaps go through gel phase, and do I put them in the freezer or whatever? The answer is yes, they do go through gel phase. All of my soaps gel, however, I do not insulate any of them. They're in the Brambleberry 5-pound wooden slidey mold, and I think the wood is just thick enough on the sides that it kind of just holds it in there, and it does go through a complete gel phase. Yes, they do. I never put my soaps in the freezer. I never put any fans on them. I take them and I pick them up and I put them in my room and I don't cover them. The only thing I do is spray them with 90% rubbing alcohol. Jennifer Davis asked me, how do you feel about math and science? I hate them. That's kind of a horrible thing to say, but I really do. I made it through Algebra 2. I never did geometry. I just couldn't do it. Like, my brain literally just could not think that way. And as far as science goes, I really, really, really liked biology. I took biology for a second time in high school, and I made a 100 as my final grade. And my mom wasn't the teacher, so we can't say, well, you were homeschooled. Nope, my mom wasn't the teacher, so I actually took a class separate from being at the house. So I was just good at it because I just loved it so much. Miss Margaret asked me if I'm a vegan or a vegetarian, or if I just make my soaps that way. I wish I was self-disciplined enough to be a vegan or a vegetarian. However, I just like bacon too much. No, it's really just I make my soaps that way so that it can be friendly and appeal to most everybody. I think that coconut milk is just as good as goat's milk, if not better, when it comes to bubbles. So yeah, I just make vegan soaps. I'm not a vegan myself, though I do try to maintain a very, very healthy and organic lifestyle. My mom pretty much got us to doing that about 5 years ago. She makes our own bread from her grain that she grinds, and she makes our own oatmeal. And we try to buy raw foods and organic foods and unprocessed meats as much as possible. And we eat very little dairy over here, so I do have a very, very healthy lifestyle, but I'm not completely vegan or vegetarian. Nikki Walker asks about bamboo silk. I am going to leave a link to the Etsy shop where I bought it. I bought mine from the Joyful Sheep Etsy shop. That's where you can buy bamboo silk. Jenny Duncan asked me if I've always lived in Texas. The answer is no. I was actually born in Fort Campbell, Kentucky, on a military base. My dad was in the military for 7 years. He was in both Army and the Navy, so yay, Dad! And so yeah, I wasn't actually born in Texas. I lived in Georgia for a while, again, while we were in the military. And then I came home and I have been a Texas girl ever since. Miss Jamie asks, let's see. You have a very glam Hollywood 50s vibe. Do I? I never would have guessed. Yes, actually, I am very, very in love with vintage, and I do try to reflect that in my, at least my physical style. I didn't know that actually it was coming out in the way that I talk or the way that I say things or the phrases that I use. That's absolutely fabulous. I didn't know that I was doing that, so great. But yes, I do love the vintage style, and I just think that the old, from the 20s to the 50s, is just a very glamorous and almost outlandish lifestyle. Everyone did things that are, you know, bigger than life today. Everyone dressed up more to do normal things and, you know, went out and, you know, there was prohibition and everyone was politically active and it was just an exciting growth time for America. So yeah, I've been kind of passionate about that for at least 2 or 3 years and do try to implement it in my everyday style. Miss Natasha asked, do you consider doing high tops on your soap, your signature, or do you sell in stores? I do not currently sell in stores except for the one boutique, which is in Brooklyn, New York. Yes, I do. High tops, I do consider to be my signature. I don't really know what made those so appealing to me. I made them one day and I was like, this is it. This is what I need to do. So yes, all of my artisan soap bars do have high tops on them. And I do kind of think of that as my signature. Oh, it was Miss Vicky who asked about coming to the UK. And yes, I will come see you in Yorkshire. Yes, I will. Another question that was asked a long time ago is, do I have a dad? Yes, I do. I do have a dad. I know I never mention him and he's never in the videos, but he's a working man and he has a family of 10 to support, so that's why you don't see him very often. But yes, love my dad very much. He's very much been an active part of my life. Neither of my parents have ever been divorced, and I think this is their 24th anniversary this year, so yes, he's still around. I've had another request to see the Dynacat. Here is the Dynacat! Dynacat is mine. She is also my my royalty soaps spokesperson. Aren't you Dynacat? She's a very lively little thing. She's still very scrumpy. Last time you saw her was on my tea video and she was a kitten, but yes, she's still very cuddly. And she is always with me. Every single time I make soap, she is down in the shed with me sitting somewhere. And now she's being all mellow and stuff. So this is Dinah. This is my Dinah. Say bye, Dinah.
Bye. Dinah says bye.
Another question that I got, which really made me laugh, was somebody asking me, who is the cat? Because in my videos, I refer to somebody as the cat. Who is that? As actually my beau, or my boyfriend, as some people in America probably call him. He is the man that I am courting, and I dislike calling him the cat because he's very cat-like. He's kind of introverted and very, very quiet and a little bit cynical, which is really funny because y'all know me and I couldn't be more extroverted and more happy and excited, but yes, he's very kind of quiet. But we balance each other out fantastically. We've been together for 8 months now and I don't think that's going to change, and I don't know. We're hoping for a royal wedding. I am doing another giveaway. Yes, I am. At 5,000 subscribers, we will be doing another giveaway. Yay! Another one from Miss Jenny Duncan is, what is your favorite part of growing up with a big family? And that would have to be that you are never lonely. I mean, never. I love people. I love them. And so I am never without them. And like my family, whenever they went for spring break, I miss them so much. I was just walking around here. I had plenty of soap stuff to do, but I was just dragging on like, where are my people? She also asked, I know you collect pins. Do you also collect fascinators? I do collect pins to go on my soap making suit, which is pretty decked out and fabulous by now. I don't have a fascinator. If I had a fascinator, my life would be complete. I adore them, and it's another one of those vintage things that I would love to have. I'm actually going swing dancing pretty soon with my best friend Joanna, and so that would be a good time to wear it, maybe. I don't know. I don't know. I have to find one because I absolutely love them. So no, I don't have a collection, but I should. Editing software for my videos. I use VideoPad. I think it was like $40. And I've been using that for a while. I used Windows Movie Maker before that. I don't have a Mac. I have Windows. Yay, PC. Woo! Represent. But a lot of my video editing is kind of done on the camera now. Like, I do all my lighting settings and adjustments and volume and whatever on the camera, and then I take it into VideoPad and do all the transitions and do all the cutscenes and things like that. Last question is, do I have a favorite artist, musical artist at the moment? I love lots of people, but I tend to lean toward lesser knowns, indie alt, kind of people. And the people I'm enjoying right now are Birdie, The Neighborhood, let's see, The Classic Crime, Emery, and probably Demon Hunter, which is actually a metal band, which I know doesn't really fit me at all, but it's the cat's problem. He's a bass player and enjoys metal, and he kind of hooked me a little bit on it. None of the nasty, creepy stuff, just the good stuff. So I hope you all have enjoyed this video. I hope all of these questions that have come my way were properly answered and you thought that I did a good job. And if you did, you can give this video a thumbs up. And if you really liked me, you can subscribe. Pretty soon here, we're going to start the new Secret Soap collection. And I also have a very, very special video that I'm going to be doing with someone who's very, very near and dear to my heart. Thank you all very much for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye for now.